Next up is Jane Wu, Managing Director at Nervos Foundation. She will be talking about common knowledge base, past and future. Welcome, Jane.
Hello, everyone. It's glad to be here today, and I want to thank Bitmain for inviting me to this conference, along with great peers working on proof of work. My name is Jane, and I'm with Nervos Foundation. Our mission is to support and grow the ecosystem around the common knowledge-based blockchain, which is a proof of work smart contract platform. Before I go any further, I want to take this opportunity to say thank you to CKB miners. I met some of you earlier today. Thank you for your contribution in security our blockchain. I also want to point out that Nervos Foundation does not fund any ASIC production or participate in the mining business. We never have and we never will. There is a conflict of interest and we stay neutral. What I'm sharing today is not any type of advice, but my, thank you, but my observations of how ecosystem grow. So bootstrapping a POW chain has been exciting yet very challenging journey. What is common knowledge base? You probably have seen this picture. Blockchain is a trust machine. When we say we trust Bitcoin, the underlying implication is that we trust the Bitcoin blockchain. It is used to trust. It is used to create a trust during the consensus process, where all network participants reach a common agreement about the current state of a blockchain. In this context, common knowledge refers to state verified by a global consensus. So in Bitcoin, a UTXO stores numbers to represent how many Bitcoins you have. And money is the common knowledge stored in the blockchain. If we take this one step further and use an extended UTXO to store and validate more kinds of common knowledge, like digital assets, smart contracts, identities, zero knowledge proof, that's what CKB is trying to do. So the CKB core team have built or contributed to a handful of open source projects since 2014, which include Ethereum enterprise blockchain, wallets called mToken, mining pool, and exchange. In 2018, the core team decided they are ready for a bigger challenge. That's when we started building CKB. And this time, they want to build something differently. So CKB is a smart contract platform, and the scalability of a smart contract platform has always been a problem. The reason we wanted to use a blockchain instead of a database because it's decentralized, permissionless, and secure, not because it's fast. But with more crypto economy activities growing on a blockchain, we want it to be faster so it can compete with existing systems and it can enable more use cases. However, it is not possible to achieve a high level of security, decentralization, and scalability on one single blockchain. So Nervos use a layered approach. We have CKB as the foundation of the Nervos network. CKB was designed to do less, focus on security and decentralization, with the intent to work well with a number of powerful layer twos. And layer two, they can focus on scalability and provide transactions to millions of users as fast as they can. So CKB generates trust and extends the trust to all upper layers. To do this, it must deal with reliable preservation of any data and assets stored on it, which is a big task. So it has to be minimal, flexible, and most importantly, keeping the permissionless nature and be secure. That's basically why we use proof of work. The consensus participation in POW is truly open and permissionless. It's fair and reliable. I'll dive in a bit here. So there's a lot of debate over POW with POS. Both have the risk of leading to monopolization. But long-term monopolization is more difficult in POW, just because it's so competitive. And I bet you have better idea than me. So the fast change landscape of regulation, mining, equipment, energy access, and poor operation makes it very difficult for one actor to have a monopoly for a long time. But with POS, stakers have less friction and more power to stay in control. Secondly, early participants in POW do not receive any particular advantage over new participants. Miners and mining pools must continue to invest and adapt to win block rewards. But the POS rewards are issued to holders of staked coins. Those who get in first can acquire a percentage of issuance at a relatively low cost and continue to accumulate block rewards at near zero cost. Lastly, it's very reliable. Bitcoin has been running for 14 years, and POW is well battle-tested. So CKB's consensus is called Nakamoto Consensus Max, which is an evolved version of Bitcoin's consensus. NC Max can maximize transactions per second and decrease confirmation time. CKB's TPS can reach to 100 to 200. But the key point here is, when bandwidth and latency improve in the future, the network capacity can grow as well. So we believe crypto of its origin is to replace the existing system where social trust can be fragile. Blockchain is a trust machine that should be used to create a better system than what we are trying to replace. Not the same, not worse. CKB is one of the very few smart contract platforms that use proof of work. This comes from this belief. A public, permissionless infrastructure has to be as decentralized, secure, and neutral as possible. So, common knowledge base has a quite uncommon situation with ASICs. The mainnet was launched November 2019, and our first ASIC came out 4 months later.
So far, as I'm aware, there are five different ASIC manufacturers that have shipped 10 different ASIC, CKB ASICs. So how does this happen? Firstly, we believe ASICs is inevitable, and in the long term, it's good for the security of the network. So we are not anti-ASIC, and we are not going to change the hash algorithm. Secondly, we use a new hash function called EagleSum. It takes millions to make a new ASIC. The more complicated the hashing process, the higher the cost, which is not good for small players. EagleSum is an extremely simple hash, making the CKB ASIC design a low-hanging fruit, and it lowers the barrier and cost for hardware development. Thirdly, we put quite a lot of efforts in reaching out to miners in early days. So we had five rounds of mining competition during our testnet of 5 months. And there were over 10 mining pools supporting CKB when we launched mainnet. So based on the hash rate, we suspect it's already GPU mixed with FPGA mining when we launched mainnet. And then ASIC came out 4 months later. So that's basically our practice in decentralizing the ASIC production, which I believe is a very important step towards proof of work, towards keeping proof of work with all its benefits relevant for more permissionless consensus participation. Okay, so here we come to the part about mining rewards. CKB, as we said, is initial for the common knowledge-based blockchain. is also the initial for native token CKByte. One CKB allows an owner to store one byte of data on the blockchain, and it's also used to pay transaction fees. So this part is, you know, could be a talk of its own. I will just briefly introduce what our issuance look like. CKB has a base issuance like Bitcoin. It halving like every 4 years, and we also have secondary issuance. So when a miner mines the block, they would receive the base issuance and a portion of secondary issuance. The portion is based on state occupation. If half of the CKB in circulation are being used to store state, a miner would receive half of the secondary issuance reward. When Nervos base issuance eventually ends, miners will still receive state rent income that is independent of transactions. This design is to make sure miners have incentive in securing the blockchain in the long term. You can find more information about our token distributions on our white paper and also Explorer. So, we have shared some of the design thoughts behind CKB. What's unique feature that CKB could provide as a smart contract platform to developers? I want to make an analogy here. So the internet today is powered by a suite of interoperable protocols. When users, they visit internet, they browse content, they interact with applications, which are like hosted on different server and owned by different owners, but the users won't feel anything. However, that is not the case with the blockchain world today. To interact with a dApp, users have to go through the progress of setting up a specific wallet, and applications built on different chains cannot interact with each other easily. CKB made a difference here. Applications that running on CKB is widely accessible to users from other blockchains. For example, on left of screen, Dobit is a decentralized identity on CKB, but users can purchase and manage a Dobit account from Ethereum wallet, Polygon wallet, even a Dogecoin or Bitcoin wallet in the future. That is because CKB is very flexible. The default cryptographic primitives like the hash function and the signature verification algorithm adjust the smart contracts running in CKB virtual machine. Developers can select the cryptographic primitives in smart contracts by themselves and even use the existing internet infrastructures directly. For example, Apple Passkey allows users to log in, use biometric info instead of passwords. And Join ID is a non-custodial wallet that will support Apple Passkey. It will allow users to create a CKB wallet using Touch ID or Face ID, and they only need to authorize with biometrics when creating transactions or interacting with smart contracts, which is very convenient and safe. So to say, we have this building account abstractions in CKB. And because of its flexibility, I believe CKB has a unique position in a multi-chain world today as a hub for connecting users from different blockchains and onboarding Web2 users to Web3. So this year, we have made some remarkable progress. We have our first major protocol upgrade, aka hard fork, after 3 years, and we'll have another mainnet upgrade next year before our first halving. Dobit, the ID that on our layer one already has over 60,000 users, unique addresses. And in terms of layer two, we launched an EVM equivalent layer two called Godwalken, which is the first OP rollup running on UTXO chain so that we can onboard Solidity developers. We are about to release a high performance layer two framework with native Cosmos IBC support. We are also actively exploring the new user scenarios on both layer one and layer twos, and the governance tool for distributing the ecosystem fund. Bootstrapping a POW network is never easy, and we are really, really grateful for having an engaging community that shares the same belief with us. Together, we'll continue to build, to learn, to to brainstorm and to grow. So may the power be with us. And thank you for taking time today. Muchísimas gracias. You can follow our updates on our Twitter account. Thank you.